Tonight, keep your eyes on the road and your hands upon the wheel. You're about to leap off the starting line with 20 expert drivers.
The first drive-through bike shop.
Oh!
Fueled up and ready to impress you with their motoring skills on land.
Coming through!
At sea. Oh. And wherever else the road takes them.
This is one of the greatest Porsche commercials I've ever seen.
Unbelievable!
Get ready to rage down the road Amish style.
Stop your frickin' buggy!
And you won't believe who's behind the wheel of this van. We've got brilliant instruction.
Back out slowly now. I think we're good.
And solid mechanical support from our celebrity pit crew.
This show has f***ed me up.
truTV presents World's Dumbest Motorheads. And it all starts now.
Oh, my God, you okay?
Hey, doesn't that pickup match the description of a hit and run from earlier today?
Take that, coppers!
See you later, suckers! Woo! Boom, jackass!
You know what? I think that was the guy from the hit and run. Because he just did it again.
Don't sit down, my friend! Woo! Don't worry, copper! I got your back!
Aren't the police supposed to be chasing him?
Where are you going, sunshine? Where are you going? Come here! Come here! Somebody needs a little love tap.
Woo! I'm coming for you, coppers.
He's gaining on us. Hurry up.
I'm trying. Wait, were we chasing him at one point?
Somebody needs a spanking. That turns me on.
I feel like this guy's no fear window decal is implied.
How about we do that again, huh?
That's it. I give up.
The run part of the hit and run, not working for you.
No, no, no! Damn it, no! All right, time out, time out, time out.
He was sort of managing to elude police, but not a stationary railing.
I had never seen a flip like that in my life, and I've seen some pretty good flips, all right?
Charged with hit and run, DUI, aggravated fleeing, and aggravated battery.
Well, look who it is, Mr. Hit and Run.
Yeah, you're gonna be hitting prison and running from shower time.
Good one.
No! Damn it! All right, just gonna go ahead and say it. Oh, sorry.
Easy one, Doc.
Long-distance mountain bikers are racing across the South African savannah.
I'm right on your tail! You'll never catch me! I'm right on your tail! It's an antelope! What? It's an antelope!
And that's why you never hear about Lance Armstrong going for the Tour de Africa title.
It's an antelope! What? It's an antelope coming!
This is how I take my men down. Come here!
Is that where the deer and the antelope play? Because it seems pretty violent.
Bro, you're not going to beat an antelope no matter how hard you pedal.
I swear to God, when these bicyclists come by, it's going to take out the first one.
Yep.
Could have been worse. Could have been an elephant.
Okay, dude. I don't.
Suddenly, he could only speak antelope.
The biker walks away with a mild concussion, some whiplash, and a new
appreciation for life in the wild.
Kids, that's why you always wear your helmet when you're biking. You could get hit in the face with a flying 440-pound antelope. It happens.
Okay, here's your change. Okay, thank you. It'll just be another minute, okay?
Well, young lady, you have done just great so far. I think you're going to be an excellent driver.
Hooray! No more carpool with boyfriend Pimp Asil.
Anyway, as soon as the attendant is done, we'll take off.
Okay, attendant is done. We take off.
No, wait.
Wait.
That's gotta hurt.
Look, being a Turkish gas station attendant isn't all glamour and fun. There's some sh** parts, too.
Okay, here's your change. Thank you. Let me just top it off a bit for you, okay? Then you can go.
Who pays den dashes?
Yes, Turkey. What the f*** we expect?
Man, talk about getting hosed at the pump. Where's my rim shot?
I was just trying to top off the gas tank.
Sorry, man, but that's what you get for wearing sandals on the job. Be a little more professional next time.
The gas attendant is taken to the hospital, but is not seriously injured.
This is why in America we pump our own gas.
Oh, wait.
Asil will not be pleased. I think that was his cousin.
Amish on the run.
Can you spike strip a horse and buggy?
And Grandma goes shopping.
Granny's sense of her own independence is really worth it.
Then later.
Please be alive so we can keep making fun of you.
When World's Dumbest Motorheads continues.
People of the earth, but they are a pain in the ass, those buggies.
It's clear that this cop has a very professional tone.
Stop your frickin' buggy!
Stop your frickin' buggy! You guys, I asked you to stop like 5 times!
I cannot hear now of the roar of thy loud devil engine.
Yeah, pay no attention to the modern devil woman. You're doing just fine. You'll have your buggy license in no time.
You guys need to stop!
You shouldn't be trying to outrun the cops if you know at some point your vehicle will have to take a sh**.
Or another pull over. Let's see what they got to say here. What? What's the problem? Listening to me. I need to talk to you. Where did the other guy go? You need to come here with me. Come here. Come, Becky. Who are these people?
It's never occurred to me to give a cop the silent treatment, but it kind of works.
You have to stop when police are after you.
For what reason did you have to suffer me?
You were not pulling over.
Do you know the straw hat law?
What the f- is the straw hat law.
I tried to look up the straw hat law, but apparently the Amish have not put it on the internet.
Our laws are more important than your straw hat laws.
Hey, straw hat law fan.
I'll give you a straw up right up your ass.
I ought to use that the next time I get pulled over.
It turns out there is no straw hat law, and the driver is cited for obstructing an officer.
They weren't obstructing an officer. They just weren't going to take orders from no woman wearing pants. Tain't natural.
Stop your frickin' buggy!
An 85-year-old California woman drives her granddaughter to the bicycle store.
Grandma, I want my new bike!
Yes, dear.
Grandma, stop messing practicing with that radio.
I'm on that Sinatra station. Where is that Sinatra station?
And just like that, the greatest generation has worn out their welcome.
Whoa, every bike is trashed? Wait, you mean to tell me I shaved my legs for nothing?
Yeah, bike is great physical therapy.
Look out, look out!
The hell?
To the girl who's already on crutches, God hates you. Watch your back.
It's my last day on crutches, and to celebrate, I'm going to Rock and Road Cyclery. Woo!
What's that?
Look out, look out!
No one is seriously injured.
I'm glad she okay, but please take her keys.
But the accident causes nearly $60,000 in damages, and Grandma's car is totaled.
This car is a great deal. It used to belong to a little old lady, and she only drove it through a store every so often.
Let's go over to Scooter World instead.
Grandma, I want my new bike!
I told your mother not to adopt you. You're so annoying.
So you have fun with that bike now, okay, buddy? All right, you sure you don't want extended warranty now, all right? Okay.
In Russia, Russian man prepared to take brand new Russian motorcycle for Russian test spin.
Okay, let's see what this motorcycle can do, huh?
This is gonna be bad, isn't it?
Okay, get ready. You're going to be eating my dust in a minute. Hang on. Hang on, wait.
It seems like most motorcyclists we see on this show are riding a motorcycle for the very first time.
Okay, here we go. This time for real. Watch like a rocket ship blasting off. Boom! What the hell is happening with this thing?
Somebody needs lessons.
I think the motorcycle stalling was its way of trying to save itself.
Okay, third time is charm. Here we go.
Okay, all right, looks like he's got it. But there's gotta be a reason we're showing this.
Check me out, you son of a bitch! I am driving motorcycle!
Ah, there it is!
Yes, I am living my dream!
Oh, there goes that new bike smell!
Really, no response from the cameraman? Nothing.
No wonder people drink in Russia. No one gives a about each other.
Driver is unharmed, but faces hefty repair bills and lifetime of shame.
You just bought this bike.
Back already? Whoa! You should have bought the extended warranty. You can buy another bike for me, okay? Maybe something not so much power. I'll make something nice.
In Indiana, police pull over a driver with a broken headlight.
What's the problem?
Huh?
What's the problem?
Hey, anything to drink tonight?
No.
Nothing to drink?
Nothing.
Okay. I assume you smell something in the vehicle.
Well, that's probably my bourbon-scented car deodorizer.
Want to step back here?
Out the car?
Yes. Are you ready to begin?
Yeah.
Okay, begin. No, you're holding on to the vehicle. You gotta come away from the vehicle. You gotta get your hand off the vehicle.
Okay, I grab the car, stop the earth from spinning, and you're mad. Take it off, and you're mad. I'm starting to believe you're prejudiced against drunk people. Officer.
I'm gonna follow my finger with your eyes and eyes only. Don't move your head. You're moving your head. You're moving your head, bud.
Nah, I'm moving my head because I'm drunk.
Move your head.
Right there.
Are you going to do the test or not?
Well, I did. That guy just came here, though. That's all.
I don't care about the guy.
Okay.
Really? That guy somehow made you drunk by walking by? Is he some kind of booze fairy?
Hell yeah, Mr. Policeman. You keep these streets safe. Sucks to be you, little dockers.
Will you take the certified test?
I don't know what a certified test is.
You go to a breathalyzer. above a .08, then it's DUI.
Then what happens?
Then you're placed under arrest for DUI.
All right, where's the option where I don't get arrested?
The test does what?
Test me whether you're intoxicated or not.
And if it's over 08, what happens?
You go to jail.
And then what happens?
You gotta poop in front of other people, you might get your ass kicked a few times. You know, jail stuff.
So you're gonna take the test.
So what happens?
I just told you what happened.
Could you repeat it?
Yeah, I think I'm getting the rules here. But just to clarify, is there any way you could, like, maybe grade me on a curve?
Turn around, put your hands behind your back.
What happens to me on that?
Turn around, put your hands behind your back.
Okay.
Turns out the driver is Ohio State Representative Robert Mecklenburg.
Release your hand.
Okay.
He is arrested and charged with DUI and has since resigned from office.
I am really glad that Congress has finally reached a bipartisan agreement to get down.
And if it's over 08, what happens?
You go to jail.
And then what happens?
Coming up.
Coming through!
Funeral crasher. And a real driving whiz.
Get on the ground.
Then later,
take me out.
How many spectators will get taken out by this motorhead?
No.
Oh, God, I don't want to look.
Find out when World's Dumbest Motorheads continues. Our countdown travels to England, where a man speeds through the streets in a stolen forklift.
Coming through! Coming through! Move your bloody eyes!
Prince Harry, you lovable rascal. What are you up to now?
See you later, alligator!
Vehicle is now off-road, off-road.
He's got to pull over soon. It'll be tea time.
Whoa, let's do a little bit of yard work, shall we? Trim the old edges.
Oh, my. He's nicked a hedgerow.
And I'll visit me poor dead mom, too. Hello, mom.
Yep. Knock down a handful of grey stones.
Rest in pieces, Grandma.
I've got a bone to pick with this motorhead. Sorry, dead person! You're all dead!
The chase comes to an end when the forklift blows a tire.
Oh, whatever.
The vehicle stopped. Yeah, he's out. Officers are with him. Now detained.
The man is found guilty of theft, damage to property, and driving without a license.
I'm sorry!
He is sentenced to 4.5 years in prison.
Nice to know this grimace skull will be behind scars! Sorry, love!
Now remember, the key to getting your jet ski license is to be able to pretend this is about twice as fun as it actually is.
Woo-hoo! Oh, yeah! Look at me! I can't wait to make my friends watch this video. Those Facebook likes, they're as good as mine.
Woo-hoo! Jet skis are like cough syrup. They're only fun if used incorrectly.
That's a big one, Danny.
Thank goodness he's wearing a helmet cam so we can see how an idiot views the world.
The trick is to swim under the biggest waves and wait for the dumbest jet skiers.
Maybe he'll fall off, I'll kiss him, and I'll get my legs finally. Finally.
Jet ski license, not your pilot's license.
Woohoo! Oh, shit. I know what I'm doing.
Thanks for dropping in. Do you want to go to the fish concert with us?
Did you bring any food with you? You are the food. Oh.
I'm videotaping this, I guess, so that my friends know how I died?
Please be alive so we can keep making fun of you.
Okay. So much for that.
Yeah. This is exactly why I don't take advice from Australian people. They don't know sh.
Quick as you get it before it breaks.
Come on, let's go again.
In Long Island, New York, where the traffic is heavy, a deputy sheriff patrolled in his Chevy.
Looks good.
While slow-moving drivers were angry and prickly,
come on!
The HOV lane moved along pretty quickly.
HOV!
Then something quite odd caught the deputy's eye.
Huh?
A strange-looking girl in a car that whizzed by.
Whee!
The driver, he noticed, a typical lady, had a passenger who was a wee bit shady. Her posture was stiff, her skin a weird hue. Her face never changed, and her hair was strange, too.
Huh.
And although the weather was cloudy and gray, the woman wore shades as she traveled that day.
Oh.
So the cop hit the siren and waylaid the pair and said to the driver,
"Ma'am, who's your friend there?"
"She's not feeling well,"
said the one at the wheel. But the sheriff looked closer and sussed out the deal.
What the hell?
The passenger, silently sitting beside her, was a mannequin dressed up to look like a rider. The driver had done this, now it seemed plain, so that she could drive in the HOV lane.
"Well, I am a senior."
She thought that this trick would get her ahead. But it got her 2 points and a big fine instead.
Ah, f*** me.
So, Long Island drivers, you'd best learn the ropes. Riding with dummies is strictly for dopes.
In New Mexico, police pull over a suspected drunken driver.
Driver, exit the vehicle.
What did you say? What?
Driver, exit the vehicle.
I cannot hear you.
Driver, exit the vehicle.
One more time, please.
Driver, exit the vehicle.
I'm starting to think he might not exit the vehicle.
Never exit the vehicle the first time when the cop tells you. It makes you look desperate.
Driver, exit the vehicle.
What is that sound? Do you have an old-timey payphone in your car?
Operator, put me through to Klondike 440. Yeah, we got a wheelman belly full of hooch here. Funny juice, Irish bathwater. I'm talking booze, see?
Get out of the car. Hold up. Time out. Pee break.
Well, when you gotta go, you gotta go.
I've been to jail, and you don't want to wait to go to the bathroom in jail.
I think I would have pissed in my pants and kept going.
Ground, there's piss all over it.
Yeah, you enjoy the show?
I'm back
you
here.
Pervert!
I'm back here.
You come back here, bitch.
This is a great combo, peeing and then giving someone a double bird. I'm into it.
You all suck, but I just pissed on the road. Woo!
The truck doesn't get far before it runs over a set of spike strips.
All right. Put your hands up.
What's up?
Yeah, from now on, you'll be doing your urination from behind bars. I'm old-timey, like my phone, capiche? Yeah, I got it.
What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do?
First, the driver shows the cops his beanbags. Then the cops show him theirs.
The driver is arrested and taken to the hospital for treatment. He later pleads guilty to DWI and aggravated fleeing.
More like aggravated peeing. Am I right? Whatever.
Coming up, a car thief with fine taste.
The amazing chase. Unbelievable. Fire at the bank.
If you're gonna steal a car, steal a Porsche.
Stopping your truck.
Put your foot back in the truck.
With your foot?
I do it with my bicycle. Why can't I do it with the 2-ton truck? I don't understand.
Then later, you'll never guess who's driving this van.
Are you kidding me?
Find out when World's Dumbest Motorheads continues. Police pursue a joyrider who has just stolen a late model Porsche.
We just spotted the stolen car.
I'm interested in stealing a Porsche, but if I do, am I just that guy?
It's getting dangerous now. It's riding through local homes here.
Hey, slow the f*** down! It's a residential neighborhood, you dumb son of a bitch!
Enos, put your kibbles and bits away. It's 10 a.m.
Take that speed going off-road there. Into the guardrail. That's a hardy.
This is one of the greatest Porsche commercials I've ever seen.
I've never seen anything like this. Jesus, simply a man. Oh, just hit another driver with his front wheel. Is he okay? Coming up. He's okay. That driver's okay. And our man is still going strong on just three wheels.
I've got three wheels, but I can still handle better than you guys can. Ha ha! You coppers can't catch me. Here's my accent.
The Motorhead manages to get away.
We got a runner! A runner!
And quickly steals another vehicle.
All right, looks like he's picked up some sort of a suburban vehicle. It is. Slow.
Well, it makes sense. His bumper sticker says, my other car is whatever I can steal.
And still going on this, it looks something there. It's a very slow chase, eh? And, into a tree.
After a two-hour chase, the driver is finally detained.
That was unbelievable.
You know, I haven't seen my boyfriend in a long time, so at least now I know what he's been up to.
The man is charged with auto theft and dangerous driving.
The thief was brought to justice, no one was hurt, and some flashy had their Porsche destroyed. That's what I call a perfect day.
Simply amazing driving here. Into another guardrail. That'll do it.
Behold, I am Wheelios, god of motorcycle trickery. I'm the guy that makes sure motorcycle tricks go off without a hitch. But let's watch this mortal do a stoppie. Ma, it's entry level. Okay, it's like the mailroom of the gods. That's how it works up here.
Oh, dude.
Did he go yet?
Yes, go.
My bad, buddy. I lost focus. It was my mother. How you feeling?
Lie down, bro. You might be better off lying down.
Cheers. Sorry.
Man, you guys won't believe this. I heard, like, voices. It was saying, Eric, you got a big old wanker.
That may have been my nephew, Felios. Got a creepy comments.
Eric, call me.
I'm sensing another guy attempting to do an old-fashioned wheelie.
Woo! Do the wheelie!
Yeah, so what are you doing later? You know, my cousin Poseidon's got this really sick hot tub.
Do the wheelie!
Shouldn't you be watching that guy?
What guy?
Check me out!
Oh, sorry about that, buddy. It's these broads up here. They got me crazy. Nice catch from the guy in a vest. Way to look out, buddy. Looks like you might have banged up that car. But don't worry about it. My other cousin, Midasopolis, he's the god of auto repair. Hey!
Oh, yeah, no problem. I'll give you the family rate.
Okay, no more screw-ups. The next guy, I'm gonna give him my full, undivided attention.
Okay.
Yes, he's looking good. No! What in the Hades was that? That's not on me. That's my bro, Carnot Crashius. He's supposed to handle that. Where's that guy?
Yes, go!
What a knucklehead. Anyway, thanks for coming by the south side of Mount Olympus. And remember to ride safe. I can't see everybody all the time, so wear a f***ing helmet.
Michigan police notice a pickup truck driving erratically.
Pull the truck over to the side of the road. Pull the truck over to the side.
I do it with my bicycle. Why can't I do it with the 2-ton truck? I don't understand.
Son of a bitch!
Are you wearing boots? Okay. Because otherwise, this could get a little dangerous.
It's Michigan, man. Just keep on driving until you hit an auto parts factory.
Turn the ignition off! Turn the ignition off!
All right.
It was either that or throw an anchor out the back.
Why didn't he think of that earlier?
Now that's the walk of a man who was going places in this world.
I'd like to order some brake pads, size 11 and a half, preferably in a loafer.
The hot-footed motorhead is taken into custody. He is charged with reckless driving and driving with a suspended license.
Doesn't that rockhead know how to stop a car? You gotta throw both your feet on the ground at once.
You sure said a rock full, Fred.
Let's get out of here. I wanna go shopping on Rockdale Drive.
Then let's stop at Baskin Rockins for the kids.
Yay, go, go, bam, bam.
Man, this show has really gotten stupid. But it's a living.
Hello, Dum Dum.
Coming up. Hit. And run.
He's way better at running than he is at driving.
Plus, a real stick in the mud.
I bet he wish he had doors on that Jeep now.
And later.
Oh, sorry. Oh. Okay, no.
She should lose her license for at least ever.
When World's Dumbest Motorheads continues.
All right, we got our first contestant up here.
Cass, Arkansas, just one L away from class.
At the Rocktoberfest Mud Bog Racing, a driver has a few issues figuring out the course.
Oh, watch out. Get a little hung up on that rock there. A little hung up. See if you can get a spare tire up and over there.
Woo! We are sitting, drinking, and watching other guys do stuff with trucks. Does it get any better?
God, I hope so.
What?
No, I said this is great. Thanks for inviting me.
Good or bad? I'm not sure.
Don't worry, buddy. He's gonna go again.
Wait, the same guy? He gets to go again? When does this thing end?
When we run out of beers.
Give me another.
Here he comes around again. Looks like he got out of one champ.
Do they just cheer and respond to motion? Because he's not really succeeding at anything right now.
Let's see if we can get a safety crew down there and take care of this. Folks, stand back here. Stand back from the smoke if you want anyone to get hurt. It'll be all right. It'll be all right.
Is this driver the only person dumb enough to enter this race? I mean, he doesn't do very well, but it's hard to imagine anyone doing any better.
All right, looks like we're back on track here. Watch your work yourself there, buddy. And up and over.
I want to go home now. This is not fun.
Alright, now we're into the box lock. And he's going. It's slow going, but he is going, folks. Or he was going. I think he's stuck.
I bet he wish he had doors on that Jeep now.
I think I figured out your problem. You suck at this. You're welcome.
Alright, boys, we gotta get him the hell out of here. We got other people trying to drive the course.
Sport. Is it even a sport? Nobody knows. Who cares? Woo! Let's get another one of those trucks to do the things where it breaks. I don't know this guy.
Here goes on the bus later. Oh, too bad.
Our countdown takes us to a traffic stop in Nepal.
This year, explain ticket, okay? Okay?
Oh, all right, fine. Hey, look, that motorcycle's going pretty fast.
Look.
tell me where to look, I know where to look.
No, seriously, look out!
Someone's late for work.
Who in their right mind would reach out and try to grab a motorcycle and stop them?
Once you see that they're not stopping, that's when you're supposed to get out the way.
Someone needs to teach these Nepali drivers the Kathmandu's and don'ts of the road.
Breakdown. Okay, you got this guy here, and then, here comes the bike. And the next thing you know, we're all going for a ride. The cop is down, the passenger is like, ouch, and the driver is like, see ya.
He's way better at running than he is at driving.
That dude was fast as hell. Was he black?
Like Nita maids over there.
They all seem very competent in the sense of opposite day.
Okay. Oh, no, you're hurt. I don't know what I'll do. I'm jiggling around. Does that feel better? No?
No one involved in the crash is seriously injured.
I assume that since that just ran you all over, you didn't let me off with a warning, right?
Turkey now for some more Motorhead action.
Woo! Turkey! Gobble, gobble, bitches!
Okay, now we're going to back out. Just slowly now. Slowly.
I see how you do. I go slow, you charge me for extra time. Nice try, Fancy Pants. I go fast.
Okay, hello, I'm backing out here. Easy. Okay, here I come. Excuse me. Oh, sorry.
It's just one car. You can't be expected to hit no cars.
Just keep going.
Oh, okay. No, no, please, no! My bad. Sorry.
Okay, I think we're good.
What's going on in Turkey? Did they just get cars last week?
Okay, if I close my eyes, it will be okay, and everything will work out.
Because if driving in one direction leads to a crash, the safest thing to do is to accelerate.
Okay, let me text message, my friend. Tiltiness, I am backing out, whoops, into street. Send.
No matter how much Turkish delight they have, I will not be booking travel plans to Turkey.
Hey, hey.
Yes.
Are you okay?
Of course, why? Look. Why?
You crashed into cars.
I did?
Many cars.
What?
A lot of people came to her assistance, which really screwed up her chances of fleeing the scene.
Okay, I think you need to get out of car.
But I was going to drive.
No, it's better you get out of car.
So, I guess I still take bus to work at fish mill?
Actually, they don't take off as many points as you might think for that on the Turkish driving exam.
Okay, so R is for reverse, okay.
Tonight, you've collided head-on with 19 of the dimmest dingbats ever to sit behind the wheel. But the number one numbskull has yet to buckle up, and you won't believe what he's up to. Sit tight, he's just around the corner when World's Dumbest Motorheads continues. Our countdown concludes at this gas station in Michigan.
Honey, I'm so glad that we're able to spend this time together. Even if it's just driving around, it makes me feel good as a father. You know what I mean?
I'm gonna go inside.
Okay, sweetheart.
Okay, Daddy.
Okay, I'll be right with you.
Where is her mama?
You know, it's just that sometimes Daddy has too much to drink, and I can't drive myself when I'm in that condition, you know?
Hey, you know, it's a designated driver.
Is this good, Daddy?
Yup, just like that.
Now keep your hands at 10 and 2. And the best way to remember that is you drop your dad off at the bar at 10, and they usually throw him out by 2.
You made your drunk father very happy tonight, baby.
And fun.
Yeah.
Oh, I know a girl who did this for her dad growing up. She told me all about it while she was giving me a lap dance. Nice girl.
9 years old. Nice.
Frank, listen, we're leaving, and she's driving.
I just said out loud all the thoughts I was supposed to keep inside.
Here, I swear to you. 9 years old, in the truck, we're parked right here. She's rolling all the way here.
Thanks for the candy apple. This makes up for all the times we won't share together.
It's 3 a.m. and she's got to drive. Get her a cup of coffee.
A bystander calls police and the van is pulled over shortly after leaving the gas station. The father is arrested and charged with child abuse.
But no DUI, right? I'd say mission accomplished.
The first half of her first country album is already written. She just needs one boyfriend to dump her and boom, next Taylor Swift. Or that stripper thing I was talking about earlier.
Listen, we're leaving, and she's driving.
Daddy, I want a beanbag rifle.
He ain't coming back no more.
Hey, right in the beanbag.
Oh. Ooh, so hot.
Thank you.
Get down.
Not today, baby.
What's the big look? That's not professional.
Yeah! Yeah! Straw hat law, bitch! I can do whatever the f I want!
I just had a sandwich, I'm all hopped up!
Goo-hoo!
Yeah!
Motor Kid City,
Detroit! Oh!
Always work. Well, that's not good enough.
Did I get it?
Boing.
No, I can't do this anymore.
Hello, dum-dum.